He said, by Allah, if you Muslims know what I know, this is the problem. We don't know. But the Allah in Quran to tell us about many things that's hidden from us. About the day of the judgment. About the bridge and the sirat. About the day of Qiyamah. وَيُحْشَرُ النَّاسُ حُفَاهُ عُرَاهُ غُرْلَهُ كَمَا بَدَأْنَا أَوَّلَ خَلْقٍ نُعِيدُهُ وَعْدًا عَلَيْنَا إِنَّا كُنَّا فَاعِلِينَ. Imagine people coming out of their graves. No clothes, no shoes, uncircumcised, men and women in one spot. Everybody walking and walking and walking to go and be in the same place. Imagine the sun coming so close to their heads, nothing but 1 mile in distance, and everybody calling in Allah. And if la tasma'u illa hamsa, you don't hear anybody, any conversation except whispering. Everybody's scared. لَوْ تَعْلَمُونَ مَا أَعْلَمْ. If you know what I know. Yes, we know, but we don't know. Because ثُمَّ لَتُسْأَلُونَ كَلَّا لَوْ تَعْلَمُونَ عِلْمَ الْيَقِينَ لَتَرَوُنَّ الْجَحِيمَ. There is a different levels of knowledge that you know and you don't believe, or you know that you believe, or that you know and you believe but you are not certain, but you are not visualizing it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us, لَوْ تَعْلَمُونَ عِلْمَ الْيَقِينَ. If you have the real knowledge of certainty, لَتَرَوُنَّ الْجَحِيمَ. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, if you know what I know, that means if you come to realization of the seriousness of the matter, especially about Yawm al-Qiyamah, being in the grave. Imagine yourself sit in a room with no air condition for 3 hours. Imagine being in a room by yourself there for 2 nights, no lights. Try to imagine, try to feel it, try to visualize it. If you know what I know, you will laugh little. And you will weep a lot, you will cry a lot. And you are not going to have the enjoyments of your wives in your bed. And in addition to this, you'll be running out of your house to the streets and the jungles, asking Allah His protection and His refuge. My dear respected brothers and sisters, as Allah is saying, وَمَا يَعْلَمُ جُنُودَ رَبِّكَ إِلَّا هُوَ. None know the soldiers of Allah other than Allah. There is a great kingdom that we are not aware about it. There is a multitude of creation glorifying the name of Allah. There is many soldiers of Allah whipping everything ready for the word of Allah, be it will be. Who we are that we drag in our feet for the remembrance of Allah. Who we are that we did not see the house of Allah, most of us, except once a week. By Allah, if you know what I know, you will laugh little. Some of the Muslims nowadays, they laugh in day and night. They have even movies and show talks and things for laughing and nothing but laughing. It's time to wake up before it's too late. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he care for you and say, if you know what I know, you will laugh little. You will laugh little. أكثروا من ذكر هذه اللذات أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. Remember Allah, mention Allah, the destroyer of all pleasure. When death is come, the pleasure of wife, the pleasure of the house, the pleasure of the food, the pleasure of the swimming pool, the pleasure of going to Paris and going everywhere, he will come and destroy all the things. He will take it away from you. And when you say, رَبِّ ارْجِعُونَ لَعَلِّي أَعْمَلُ صَالِحًا فِي مَا تَرَكْتُ, it will be too late. Oh Allah, give me a chance again so I can do better. It's too late. Too late. Why? Why we running away from Allah? Why we running away from the house of Allah? Why we running away from the deen of Allah? We're supposed to run to Allah. We're supposed to be coming closer to Allah. Ramadan came and went. We start to get a little bit active. And after this, Ramadan is gone and as if nothing. Some of us became occasion Muslims. Will Ramadan come? And after this, when the Eid will come? And after this is gone, everything is cool and everything is fine about our own business again. Some Muslims, they don't have time for Jum'ah. SubhanAllah, your heart is getting dry. Your heart is getting dry. You don't know if you're going to make it for next week or not. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, and you will be running out of the house. When do you do this? Imagine that you're sleeping and you're comfortable and everything nice. And after this you hear alarm. Alarm. You don't know, you feel something hot. You think there is a fire in the kitchen. What you do? You don't say, oh, wait, let me put my ties and suit. Let me try to put my... You run as is. Doesn't matter what you're wearing. You will run. You don't have to go to the elevator, you run on the steps. You snatch whatever you can. You run even maybe before your child or maybe before your wife. Why you do this? Because there is something serious. The Prophet ﷺ said, if you come to know this reality, O Prophet of Allah, we have it. Read the Quran. Read the surahs about the Qiyamah. Read the surah about death. Read is there and keep reading and listening to things which remind you about Allah so you can know that the matter is serious and that is common. It's coming. Iqtarabat al-sa'a. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that the hour is already getting closer and near. Listen to the narrator of the hadith, Abu Dharr. After he narrated the hadith, he said, I wish I was a tree by the road, that a camel or an animal will come and eat me up, and this it, and this will be the end of me. This is one of the Sahaba. Those Sahaba, they dedicated the life, this deen, for studying, for learning, for jihad, for whatever it takes. Donation, give money, give anything, they ready. And after this, when he hears this hadith, he say, I wish I was a tree to the side of the road. Why? Because the tree is not going to be resurrected or accountability for Jannah or hellfire. A camel or a sheep will come and eat it up and this it. Say, I wish I was a tree to the side of the road. What about me and you? What we're supposed to say, my brothers and sisters? It's time today in Jijoma that we reflect again about our life, about our conduct. We read books every day. I'm not against books, but when you read about history, you're reading about chemistry, you're reading about mathematics, you're reading about everything every day for 6 hours, and you don't have 10 minutes to open the Quran. It's destruction. Is you're ruining yourself, you're ruining your heart, you're destroying your soul. Wake up, Muslims, wake up before it's too late. A Sahabi, a companion who observes and sees the Prophet, they say, I wish I'm a tree. What about me and you? What we're supposed to say? Let's do it before it's too late. Let's try to recognize the greatness of Allah. Allah doesn't need us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it doesn't need us. There is other creation and creature who worship in Allah. Since Allah created them, can you imagine the whole heaven, the whole sky, full with angels prostrating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Why we running away compared to Allah? فَفِرُّوا إِلَى اللَّهِ. Run to Allah.